Right. Let us learn one topic called peptide bond today. Yes, so we've learned isoelectric point, so now let us learn what is peptide bond or peptide linkage. Right. First, let us write the definition for peptide linkage. So when I'm writing the definition for peptide linkage, it is the bond formed between two amino acids by the elimination of water molecule. Of water molecule is called peptide bond.
Okay. What have I written? I've written one, two sentences. Let me try explain you what it is.
Now I said your amino acid basically tetravalent, correct? It has an amino terminal and it has a carboxylic terminal. This is your H and this is your R. Right?
R can be any amino acid, right? 20 amino acids.
Correct. Now this amino acid is going to combine with one more amino acid. How is it going to combine? Your carboxylic group facing the amino group. Yes. Now see, because I have written amino on this side, carboxylic on the other side, H and R. Okay. Now I'm writing R1, I'm writing R. Again, what happened? This carboxylic end, again it should be amino end, C, H, R. I'm writing R3 and COH. This continues. Now observe, OH from here and your H from here. Okay, hydrogen from here and OH from here is eliminated. So this H is like this, correct? Now OH from here and H from here is eliminated. OH from here, H from here is eliminated.
So what happens? Now this is going to join. Now this amino acid is going to join with one more amino acid. How does this join? NH2, NHR. Now this is here and your C, it has become C, it is already C double bond O, correct? Now this is eliminated and what do you have now? N and your H. Now C is there, hydrogen, R double bond, R prime,
so C O. So again I'm writing, right, try to make it C double bond O down, N H C H R C O H. Okay, now observe this bond where water got eliminated, this bond where water got eliminated, this bond is called peptide bond or peptide linkage or peptide bond.
Yes. Now what happened? Amino acid, they combine one after the other. Suppose if this is methionine, then next is alanine, like that. One amino acid, when they combine with another, there's an elimination of water molecule, and finally after eliminating, the C double bond O and NH combine together, and this combination of C double bond O and NH is called peptide linkage or peptide bond. So when you're writing in the exam, when you're writing this peptide bond, write it like this. C double bond O, NH, peptide linkage. You'll get half mark there only. Right, now observe. This peptide linkage, when I just go into the details of this peptide linkage, yeah, so here we said R prime. Here I've written double dash, correct? That means I'm speaking about one amino acid, I'm speaking about other amino acid. Now what are you finding? Which amino acid or which ending, it's ending with which one? It's ending with amino terminal, correct? So this amino acid, this is one amino acid, we call it as when it is ending with amino terminal, right? We call it as N-terminal amino acid. I call it as N-terminal amino acid. Now observe this. Yes, so it is ending this amino acid R triple dash we have. This is ending with carboxylic group. So this amino acid, I call it as C terminal amino acid. So simple, you have to remember. You have to always start from, it's going to start from N terminal and it is going to end to C terminal. This is the concept. Yeah.
right? N terminal to C terminal. So amino acid, if it is linking like this, one after the other, one amino acid linked to the other, one amino acid linked together, or like this, one amino acid linked together, this will be N terminal and this will be C terminal. Yes, this is what. So peptide bond, write the definition. Take two amino acids, you can always put like this. If you want to show, make this at the center and take out water molecule here, take out water molecule here and show this peptide and show this peptide and show this N terminal to C terminal. This is how it ends. It starts with N terminal and ends with C terminal. This is your peptide.